as a performer, as a dancer, I've always loved movement and the way that you can create movement using your own creativity and seeing other people and the way they pursue themselves. So that's why I wanted to go into 3D animation, is to learn more about the movement, how to create that movement in a form where you can use technology to do all that.
So when I was younger, I was like a really big fan of video games. And so I wasn't really like a fan of all the coding and all the programming that went along with it. I was more a fan of the art style of it. So I looked into it and I saw that graphic design was one of the key things. I was like, hey, that sounds a bit fun. Let me look more into it. And I fell in love with it and now I'm here doing what I love.
Gosh, I love cartoons. Who doesn't watch cartoons? Squares, I tell you what. That's a cartoon reference too, if you get it.
Yeah, I get it.
I just always want to do something with film and television. That's just always what I
want
to do.
I play a lot of video games, so I figured I wanted to get a little bit more involved in creating them. Creating them seems very interesting to me. And for some reason, I like the thought process of it. The abstract ideas of creating is great. At least I think of it that way anyway.
Yeah, so when I was coming to college, I thought about all the things that I didn't want to do. So, you know, most people think, or people tell, you know, their friends, family, oh, just think about what you like to do and then go pursue that. I'm like, well, I don't want to sit in like an office doing like business kind of things. So I thought about all the things that I didn't want to do, and that left me with a few things that I actually did want to do. It was like game design, sounds fun.
Cool.
For me, mostly is I love music. I've been playing since I was 8 years old, so it kind of just came here after going through 3 different colleges, and I kind of chose the thesis as the last resort.
Pros for my majors would be more like testing my creativity, you know, getting out of the comfort zone and pushing myself to do more than what I can do.
As far as like the curriculum wise, the curriculum is easier than I would normally have, like an NJIT or something like that. It's not heavily based on math, which is a good and bad thing.
Pros specific to Bloomfield, I think our professors are like the best.
As far as my opinion, pros would probably be like you get to meet a lot of new people, you get to use and like interact with so many different softwares. Especially like Photoshop, Illustrator, like After Effects. Those things are probably like the best things you could probably use, at least in my opinion. And it's really fun. It's probably a pros to get to create a lot of things, especially off your mind, and maybe even recreate a lot of things.
One of the best things about it is the simple fact that I'm learning Unity. It's great. You're learning Unity, you're learning Construct. You're learning all these different engines that the normal, like, how do I say, pros would use these types of engines, and it's great.
As for cons?
Cons.
Well, I mean, it's a lot of work. So anyone who's not ready for just a ton of work for long hours every day probably shouldn't be there.
One of the cons about being part of the major is that I don't think we get taken serious enough. Everyone does music these days, so people don't know what we truly go through in our classes, you know, and through our curriculum. It's not as easy as it sounds. We're not just SoundCloud artists. We're beyond SoundCloud artists.
It's a lot of work, you know, being a double major, because I constantly have to go back and forth. Yeah, it's just a lot of work, just constant work, drawing, and everything.
Con is it's not that many classes for Spanish media.
Some of the cons are in this school, so, I mean, it's pretty small. So as far as networking, it can be like a great place to network. It can also be like a pretty limited place on campus, depending on how you look at it. So yeah.
As for 3D animation, I've been loving the curriculum. It's everything that I thought would happen, you know, everything I thought I would take and everything. And at first it became stressful because I'm not used to that kind of work and used to drawing all the time. But over time I got used to it and I just love it so much. So in a sense, yeah.
A few of the classes are, but there are some classes that just kind of get in the way of what you actually want to do. We call those gen ed classes, like, you know, math, history, stuff like that.
Yes.
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 Yeah.
Like, can you elaborate more on that? Like, what would you say is helping?
Peaches? Drawing?
That works. That.
Being put to work? Like a slave.
As I said before, it's actually showing you, it's giving you exposure to these big engines. And when you utilize other engines, it's going to be a lot easier when you utilize other engines. Because Unity gives you that background. It gives you that background in C#. So other than that, yeah, that's like the bread and butter of everything that I'm going to be using in the future. Of course, coding as well. Coding is very important. Guess what? You're going to be doing in Unity, coding.
They're giving players options of what to do, creating mechanics, like how it should work, things like tweaking it. In addition to that, we have other courses that teach you those specific things that I mentioned. So we have like courses where you learn how to 3D model, how to create sound effects, recording and editing, things like that. And you get a taste of all of it in the game design major. You're not just limited to one thing, even if you may have like one or two like specific areas that you excel at that you prefer to do, I guess.
At first, I did want to go to Rutgers, and I was accepted to Rutgers, but I realized that, you know, Bloomfield, you know, even though it's a small school, I feel more connected to the professors here. I feel more connected to like students here, my supervisors and everything. It's like, I'm not just a number, kind of like how Rutgers has that system where it's just your number this, your number that, and you don't really get to connect with your professors or that many students because there's so many students in one lecture room. So I'm actually really happy here and I feel more comfortable here instead of being in like a bigger school.
To be honest, I don't know. But how to be honest, probably not, because like I really love where I am now. And like I met really, really dope people on my way here and being here. So like if I was to go somewhere else, I probably wouldn't enjoy it as much.
I really don't know. Maybe, but I might have more classes to do with film and stuff than do here.
No, I went to other places. I saw what they had to offer. William Patterson with their stupid hills. They had a whole building just for animation. They're like, look at our shiny animation building. Don't you want to come here, Sarah? And I'm like, heck no. You couldn't walk up this hill if you paid me.
So the reasons I came to Bloomfield was affordable. Because I believe it's the cheapest private school in New Jersey. It's not too far from where I live. And it was just far enough so that my parents would be okay with me residing. And major, of course.
I guess yes and no, because if I transferred to another school, like of course I wouldn't have gotten the same experience that I'm getting here. The people here are pretty good. The environment here is pretty good. The curriculum, as far as in the major, is pretty good.
I think Jarrell, one of my best friends, and John, my boss, is my supervisor. I guess both.
I'll probably have to say everyone who talks. So whether that be a professor, mother, father, cousins, aunts, uncles.
I would have to say as well, God, and I'll have to say my mom, because my mom, she's also like saints or whatever. And then my church family, I would have to give like a big shout out to them, because half of my church family are like into music and half of my friends are into music. So it's like we all have like the same interests and we all push each other.
I'd like to thank my father, my case manager from high school, and Danny Antonucci.
Antonucci, yes!
I'd like to thank my friend Aaron from back home, because back in high school we decided to start trying to make flash games or whatever. So that was really the start of me wanting to do game design. So I thank him for being with me there for that.
I guess my family?
Probably GJ Lee. She's helping me out with like setting up my courses, what I should take, what I should not take.
For me, most of my family, since when I first went to college, I didn't like the major I was in, so it took me about 3+ years to figure out what I really want to do. And it turns out Bloomfield had my major and it's close to the home, so alright, I'll take it.
it's very, very easy to get off track, and they kept me on track. They keep me on track to this day, and I'd like to thank them for that.
I was like in a place where I didn't know what to do, and John gave me this place where I was able to kind of explore what I really wanted, and just by being here and like being, you know, blessed enough to have this job here, I realized graphics is what I really wanted to do. And as for Jarrell, he just helped me finding the confidence in what I do and the creativity I make. And, you know, he's just a great pusher. Like, he just pushes me to do more than I do. He pushes me out of that comfort zone, and I'm just so grateful for both of them.
But I can edit that out.
Gang sh**. I'm out this bitch. I finished my final pitch. Out this bitch. This. Don't die.
Alright.
My
friend.
Show me your secrets. Show me all. My name is Sarah Boyd, and I'm a 2D animation major. But a minor in Kill Me. There's young people and their 3D animations. In my day, we only watched TV in two dimensions.
You didn't even have a day, so shut it.
You shut up. I had at least 3 days. I have at least 4 days to turn in my file. In your hand now, squeeze real tight.
I'll make both sides and so you decide. You'll have to. Is it worth it? It's worth all that it's worth. It's worth all that it's worth. That makes sense. It's worth all.
Trust me. Because.
Go. So, like, you or the camera?
Both is fine.
I'll look straight ahead. Should I lean into the
microphone?
Yeah.